Welcome students, I am Mohammad Tanbir Ahmed, lecturer Department of Civil Engineering, World University of Bangladesh. Today, I will teach you the subject Solid Waste Management, which belongs to the Environmental Engineering. It's really an interesting and effective subject for environmental engineers. This subject comprises 2 credit hours and lecture will be delivered weekly basis. A course profile based on outcome-based education OBE system has also attached in topic 1, from where you can find out the lecture contents, objectives, learning outcomes and course details. This is our first lecture and we have covered the lesson into the following outline of the course lecture: introduction to solid waste management, categories and sources of solid waste, objectives and elements of solid waste management. Rational means fundamental principles. That means the goals or objectives of studying this course. The primary goal of solid waste management is reducing and eliminating adverse impacts of waste materials on human health and the environment to support economic development and superior quality of life. This is to be done in the most efficient manner possible to keep costs low and prevent waste buildup. So we can say, for safe and healthy environment with low cost, solid waste management is needed. Outcomes. After starting this course, what students will able to learn? CO1, course outcome 1, that means outcomes 1. Explain the sources, types and properties of solid waste. Number 2, analyze the collection system of solid waste in Bangladesh. And the last one, a design of landfills considering resources and energy recovery. Resource recovery comprises 2 things, that is reuse and recycle. And energy recovery is the possibility of materials to use in combustion process. That we'll learn in our next slides. So at the end of this lesson or at the end of this subject, students can explain the sources and types of solid waste. That is the waste is hazardous or not, may be open dumping or not, what may be collection system, how they are finally disposed, and can they be used in landfill sites or not, etc. and so on. Now, what is waste? According to United Nations Statistics Division, UNSD, wastes are materials that are not prime product. Prime product is the product that is produced for the market, for which the generator has no further use in terms of his or own purposes of production, transformation or consumption, and of which he/she wants to dispose. That means the materials which is not further more usable is called waste. In other words, we can say the material which has no utility is called waste. Waste may be generated during the extraction of raw materials, the processing of raw materials into intermediate and final products, the consumption of final products and other human activities. So we can say in every phase of work, waste is generated. Residuals recycled or reused at the place of generation are excluded. All are waste material except which can be recycled or reused. Figure shows a symmetric illustration of the European Union legal definition of waste. This is the legal definition from European Union. This figure shows how a company produces a product, then it transfers to consumers, and from consumers it turns into waste and discarded as waste materials. If we describe this diagram, we can say a product is produced from a company can directly go through the consumers, and during production some byproducts may be produced. These byproducts can go through the consumer's hand directly, and some are used as raw material. These raw materials again used by company, and they produce something and send to consumers. The byproducts can directly go to the consumer's hand. An example may be said that in producing soap, the byproducts material glycerin can directly go to the consumer's hand. The other material are termed as waste and may be discarded as waste material. From the hand of consumers, after the uses, when the materials do not have any utility, then consumers discarded it as waste material. Categories of solid waste. There are many types of waste defined by modern system of waste management. Here is only the category, not the types, but the category of waste. First one is municipal solid waste, shortly we can say MSW. Second one, construction waste and demolition waste, shortly C&D. Third one, institutional waste, commercial waste and industrial waste, shortly we can say IC&I. Medical waste, which is also known as clinical waste, hazardous waste, radioactive waste and electronic waste. The last one is biodegradable waste. Sources and types of solid waste. This table shows the sources, types of waste generators and types of solid waste. The first source we can say residential. Here the typical waste generators are single and multifamily dwellings, and the type of waste generated from these generators were single family and multifamily dwellings are food waste, paper, cardboard, plastic, textiles, leather, air wastes, wood, glass, etc. Everything that may be produced from a residential building or residential house is termed as residential wastes and may be grouped in these types of solid waste. Second one, industrial. In industry, the typical waste generators are light and heavy manufacturing, fabrication, construction sites, power and chemical plants, and many other industry. And types of solid waste: housekeeping wastes, packaging, food waste, construction and demolition materials, hazardous wastes, ashes, special wastes. Everything that may be generated from industry may be grouped in these types of wastes. Then the third one, commercial. Here the typical waste generators are stores, hotels, restaurants, markets, office buildings, etc. that belongs commercial purposes. And types of waste from these commercial establishments may be paper, cardboard, plastics, wood, food waste, glass metals, special wastes, hazardous wastes, etc. As same as above, we can say all waste materials that may be generated from commercial establishments may be grouped in this type of waste. Institutional. The next one is institutional. Typical waste generators are school, college, schools, hospitals, prisons, government centers, etc., which belongs to institute. And types of solid waste generated here same as commercial, because institutional are same as commercial, and same products may be produced as solid waste, but from the generation, from the source of view, we can say that this is commercial solid waste and this one is institutional solid waste, only from the basis of sources of generation. And then other one is construction and demolition. Typical waste generators: new construction sites, road repairs, renovation sites, demolition of buildings. And here the typical solid wastes may be wood, steel, concrete, dirt, etc. And we can say that all waste materials that comes from construction and demolition industries may be grouped in this category. Examples of solid waste. Here is the some scenario of solid waste materials, including medical waste. Here is the comparative scenario of solid waste management in developed and developing countries. In developed countries, waste management includes reduction, reuse, recycling, composting, and landfilling. That means a complete package from generation to disposal. And in developing countries, waste management means waste dumping at a site and composting naturally. They have to do only this process due to their low budget. In developed countries, landfill is designed from engineering and environmentally point of view because they are very concerned about the environment. Otherwise, in developing countries, waste is disposed to low-lying area and it will be developed in future. In Dhaka, at Matuail, recently semi-aerobic landfill have been developed there. In developed countries, area available for developing landfills, there may be some reserve area for landfill. And in developing countries, densely populated area is limited. Recyclable material such as plastic, rubber, paper, metal, wood, etc. have no salvage values in developed countries. Government allocates funds and taking various steps for collection of recyclable material before sent to landfill. So we can say from the collection of wastes and to the final disposal, all and everything are done by the government in developed countries. Besides, in developing countries, since recyclable materials have good sale value, unemployed poor people make their living by collecting and selling them. Labor rate high, shortage of manpower. That's why many cases reproduced from recyclable materials bear more cost to some extent it is more expensive, and the reverse is in developing countries. Here, for cheap labors, product more recyclable materials are less costly, and normally developing countries do that. What is solid waste? Solid waste can be defined as the useless, unwanted, and discarded material coming from productions and consumptions. That means when a material has no utility or has not in use, the product or material may be termed as waste materials. A material is considered as waste when it loses its utility to the customer, to the customers. From Chinese, a thing can be both a raw material and waste at the same time. How they are thinking? Their thinking is so standard. They think about the disposal process of the material while they are preparing that. From the point of view, it's clear that they are so concerned about the environment. Then, necessity of waste management. Why it is need to manage waste? It's a great point to discuss. Waste management is important because improperly stored refuse can cause serious health hazards. All living organisms create wastes, but human creates far more wastes than other species. To prevent damaging the Earth's ecosystem and maintain a high quality of life for the planet's inhabitants, human must store and manage their wastes efficiently and safely. In other words, we can say basically human beings are responsible for all these waste materials. The more the world being developed, the more waste materials are generated. And as we are the only responsible for these wastes, we human beings have to manage it for the sake of our lives. Objectives and elements of solid waste management. What are the objectives of solid waste management? The key objectives of solid waste management is to minimize the adverse environmental effects caused by the indiscriminate disposal of solid waste, or we can say to make the environment safe and healthy. It's must needed. The major activities associated with the management of solid waste from the point of generation to the point of final disposal can be grouped into six functional elements: waste generation, on-site handling and storage, collection, transfer and transport, processing and recovery, final disposal. With these six functional elements, Bangladesh and other developing countries manage their solid waste. There are several words that have synonymous in common uses, although each may imply a different meaning. To avoid ambiguities, some commonly used terms are defined here. Refuse. All kinds of solid wastes from a community may be termed as refuse, and its components include all putrescible and non-putrescible wastes with the exception of human excreta, garbage, rubbish, ashes of dead animals, and industrial wastes are included in this category. In another way, we can say all waste materials may be termed as refuse. Here, putrescible means biodegradable, and non-putrescible means non-biodegradable. Garbage or food wastes. The term garbage is used to describe putrescible wastes primarily resulting from food products. They include cooked and uncooked vegetables, fruits, etc. Basically, from the name point view, food waste, we can say all food items or all food waste belongs to this category. Garbage is basically putrescible materials, that is biodegradable. The other term, rubbish, this is basically non-putrescible. This include all non-putrescible wastes except ashes. Both combustible and non-combustible substances such as paper cans, broken glass, wood, cardboard, etc. are considered in this category. Here combustible means which may cause fire, and non-combustible is opposite to that. Residential wastes. Wastes that are generated in houses and apartments and may include paper, cardboard, food cans, plastics, food wastes, garden wastes, etc. In other words, we can say all waste materials that belongs to residential establishment may termed as residential wastes. Commercial wastes. Solid wastes that are generated in commercial and service establishment such as office building, hotels, shops, marketplaces, etc. are termed as commercial wastes. As saying in previous slide, we can say the waste materials that belongs to the commercial establishment or that is produced from the commercial establishment are termed as commercial wastes. Municipal wastes. Solid wastes that are generated in residential areas and commercial institutions are termed as municipal wastes and include primarily food wastes, ashes and residue, waste from streets and sweeping, etc. Normally, municipal means society, and in municipal as well as residential establishments, there may be some commercial institutions or establishments, and the waste material generated from those two institutions are termed as municipal wastes. Industrial wastes. Solid wastes that are derived as byproducts from industrial operation and manufacturing processes are discarded as useless is termed as industrial wastes. Generally in industry, waste derived as byproducts, and the waste material which is derived from industrial establishment is termed as industrial waste. Demolition and construction wastes. These are wastes produced from demolition and or construction of buildings, roads and other structures, and usually included brickbats, concrete pieces, sand, electrical wires, pipes, glasses, etc. Generally, a developing country produce much more demolition and construction wastes rather than developed countries, because in developing countries developing process continues randomly. Agricultural wastes. Wastes that are generated from agricultural activities like growing plants, harvesting, fertilizer, animal manure, etc. are termed as agricultural waste. And we can say that the waste materials that is produced during agricultural work or agricultural activities belongs to agricultural wastes. Hazardous wastes. These wastes include toxic chemical, biological wastes, explosive and flammable wastes, which are produced from different industrial operations, hospitals and other institutions. These wastes are inherently dangerous and require special arrangement for their handling and disposal. These wastes are so sensitive that by contact with these wastes, there may be serious health hazards to human beings and other living animals and also plants. Some of them are so dangerous that they cannot be open dumping as they pollute air, such as liquid medicine, gases, etc. Resource recovery. This is a general term to describe the extraction of economically usable materials and energy from wastes. Resource recovery, that means recovery resources from solid waste. And to recover solid waste, generally there are two processes, that means reuse and recycling, which is described here below. Reuse: reclamation of material in its end use form and its subsequent use in the same form is termed as reuse. In another way, we can say use of same form of material by several times is called reuse. For example, we can say soft drinks bottles that make several trips from bottler to consumers and back again, where they are cleaned and refilled again. That means reuse. Recycling: reprocessing of wastes to recover an original raw material. We can say the transforming of material to a new one is called recycle. For example, a glass can be collected and after reprocessing it, it can be used in bottle manufacturing, and this is called recycling. In recycling process, original raw material is used to produce some another material. The basic difference between reuse and recycling is reuse is the use of same form of materials several times, and recycling is the transforming of raw material to a new another one. Integrated Solid Waste Management, ISWM. This is the most efficient solid waste management system nowadays. The Integrated Solid Waste Management, ISWM, aims to manage the waste in an environmentally and economically sustainable way. Accordingly, the twin goals of ISWM are to recover maximum possible amount of reusable materials and energy from the municipal solid waste stream through best available practices. And in integrated solid waste management system, it is most important to recover materials that may be in reuse and recycling processes. The second one is to avoid releasing the energy or matter into the environment as a pollutant. We normally burn the waste material, which is responsible for environmental pollution, and it's better to avoid it. In integrated solid waste management system, releasing energy is greatly discouraged.